First, let me start it with some history about enterprise store. So why we had to build these products. So if you were participated yesterday keynote session, so you realized, so whatever you are in the middleware sector, whether you are in the customer relationship management, or whatever the sector you are in, right now the people expecting you more user-centric experience. So the people talk yesterday called it as the celebrity experience. So even though we are in a middleware industry, that's something we can't avoid. So earlier days, a few years back, all our products, we had the one administrative console. So regardless if you are a system administrator or whatever the role, you have to come to that admin console and go through that UIs. So that's what we had. So then how we can revolutionize, or how we can improve this usability. For example, depend on the various roles, we present different views and so on. So how to modify such experience? While we are thinking on that way, so we came up with this pattern, like why don't we present two views, basically the one back office to publish something, and another another storefront that is to sell and promote your stuff. And we built pattern for the WSO2 API manager. Then eventually we re-implement this pattern for App Manage and so on. Then later we realize this is a very common pattern, not only within WSO2 but for our customers also. This is a very important tool to adopt. So later we came up with this product called Enterprise Store, and all our existing product try to leverage this product, the Enterprise Store concept. For example, some of you attend my previous talk, that is a governance registry. So governance registry use experience we redefine based on Enterprise Store. So each and every role get their facilitate view, which is the software system. And API Manager 2.0 onwards, also we will move into Enterprise Store. And also there are a bunch of new product like App Manager and Connected Devices Manager, so on. All these products use this Enterprise Store to provide the user-centric experience. And also, so in this presentation, I will describe how we internally use this Enterprise Store. In the same time, I will explain how you could use Enterprise Store to manage your digital asset. Okay, so this is a very basic introduction. The Enterprise Store is a tool to manage any type of enterprise assets. So it could be some digital asset, for example, services, document, policies, so this kind of digital asset, or physical asset, like mobile phones, IoT devices. For example, if you take our Connected Device Manager product, so we use various mobile devices as asset. So we basically, whatever your digital asset, you can represent within the Enterprise Store. So some real world example is, let's say bookshop. So you can represent your books in Enterprise Store. Or another example, let's think about let's imagine you can use Enterprise Store to manage the digital assets belong to state of California. Basically, let's say you have some public parks, you have some stadiums, so you can represent this asset to Enterprise Store. So next thing is, this is very highly flexible. For example, store, if you go to any store like Apple Store, or you can go to Android Store, so these are very customized, right? Same goes for you. I mean, if you build a store, you need great amount of flexibility. So Enterprise Store design to cater that kind of a flexibility requirement. So there are a lot of extension points. So through this extension point, you can build your own store. And also, it supports life cycles management. So you know, one of the unique features with WSO2 platform is, so we use same component and everywhere. For example, the life cycle management defined by the governance registry. The registry life cycle management is utilized by the enterprise store. And also, enterprise store comes with some subscription process and customizable store and publisher UIs. Another exciting feature is inbuilt social features, such as comments, tag, ratings, etc. And also, social network integrated. From your store, you can easily publish the asset information into Twitter, Facebook, etc. These features are come out of the box. So these are the main four components of the enterprise store. The first one is store, that is most important thing, the store, where your consumers comes and find out and subscribe with your digital asset. The second one is publisher, that is a back office. Basically, this is where your analytics or the officers come and publish or edit assets. The third one is manager yet to be introduced, but we have it in our roadmap. The last one is carbon console, that is basically for administrative tasks. So in runtime, basically you can find the publisher and store. So depending on your requirement, you can embed it, or you can have both publisher and store within the same JVM, or you can deploy publish and store separately. For example, you deploy store in the DMC and publisher within the your internal network. That's depend on your use cases. So this is the extension model. So there are a large amount of extension model, but basically we can categorize into four groups. The first one is the RxT based extension. The RxT is known as the registry asset definition model. So using this registry, governance registry, you can register assets. Basically, let's say you have an asset called your mobile phone, let's say you have an asset called your database script, so on. So you can represent custom asset by defining an XML file. So same thing we reuse in the extension, the enterprise store as well. So basically, RxT-based extension means you define your the asset attributes, etc. For example, if it is an ebook, so you define the structure of this ebook using a XML. So that is the that is how you can introduce asset type into your enterprise store. That's the first extension model. Second one is life cycle. For example, ebook has a different life cycle from a mobile application or mobile phone. So how do you define the life cycle? So you can define again the governance registry. Governance registry provides a way to define life cycle using SCXML. So that is a both this RxT and life cycle, SCXML based life cycle are proven technologies for many years, at least for 5 or 6 years with the WSO2 governance registry. So in enterprise store, we thought instead of reinventing something new, why we can't reuse these two? So we end up supporting life cycle, registry life cycle in enterprise store. So at the moment I covered two extensions. The first RxT, that is how you can introduce new asset type into your system. Second one is life cycle, how you define life cycle of your new asset types, right? So basically these two are nothing new. These are basically inherited from governance registry. The third and fourth are something we built for enterprise store, that is app extension and asset extension. That is basically about rendering, how you visualize and how you engage your asset with outside world. So the main difference is app extension is something for common for your whole application, and asset extension is particular for one particular asset. The one example, so if you I use governance registry as example, governance registry extension store, governance registry store and publisher as example. So if you go to governance registry, regardless of what is your asset, you can see the dependency graph, right? You can see the dependency graph, and you can see the asset comparison graph, etc. And you can, through the UI, you can change the notifications. But if you go to, if you just download Enterprise Store, you can't see these things, because these features are we built for WSO2 governor registry. But if you add new asset to WSO2 governor registry, for example, let's say right now we have inbuilt support for REST services and SOAP services like that. Let's say you define something called binary service. So when you define a binary service, let's say you write a XML file using this RxD model, and through the admin console you upload this new binary service as a type. Then using a SCXML, you define a life cycle for new asset types. Then once you go to publisher, you suddenly you can see this dependency graph, subscription manager options, those are appear. That because we develop these features as app extension. App extension means you only define one time, and it those are applied across the all assets, right? And if you go to governor registry REST service UI, you can see some middle of the UI, you can see some Swagger files. If you go to SOAP service, you can see WSDL file is rendered middle of the service description. That is example for asset extension. That is only specific to a particular asset type. So this is the difference between app extension and asset extension. If you have something common across the all asset type, you can define it as a app extension. And if you have something very specific to a particular asset type, you define as a asset extension. So this is basically this asset and app extension. You can define both logical and also UI extensions. Logical in the sense, for example, let's say once you add the new asset, for example, once you add the, let's say you have a new asset called let's say database script. So once you add the new database script, if you want to try out, basically you want to validate whether this new database script is valid or not, so that is some custom extension. So you can plug that logic into Enterprise Store, so that whenever you add the new database script asset instance, it will try out on a database, right? That is something additional to default behavior. The default behavior is once you add the new asset type, asset instance, it will persist in the database. And here what I am discussing is something additional. The next one is you can change the subscription button. For example, if you go to governor registry, the API manager extension, unlike other asset, we facilitate you to subscribe. There is a button called subscribe, and there are some set of buttons to generate tokens. So if you go to REST service and SOAP service, you don't have that features available. It's only available for API. That means we have implement those extensions as the asset extensions. So this both logical and also visual extensions are supported. And also REST API. This is really important for third party integrations and also for testing purposes. So if you want to integrate Enterprise Store with your existing governance registry any kind of a software system, in a, let's say like a CMS and so on, you can use this REST API. To the REST API, you can do all the CURD operations. So let me go through some examples. So here you can see the WSO2 Governance Center. So we have embedded, or we use WSO2 Governance Center use Enterprise Store to provide these store and publisher capabilities. So our asset types, so in governor registry is a very generic product, so you can write any asset types, or lifecycle also, you can have any SCXML valid lifecycle. And these are the some of the example screenshot of app and asset extension. So as I mentioned here, in the left side, you can see at the middle of the service description, you can see the WSDL file. So that is not a default behavior. So this is a asset extension. So if the asset type is SOAP service, it will render a related WSDL file middle of the page. That is a extension. For the REST services, for the REST services also, we implement a different extension, asset extension. That is, you can see down here, the Swagger UI integration. So if you go to the any Governor Registry REST service page, there is a link to that will visualize the Swagger UI page for you. But if you go to some other asset like a policy or a schema, you can't see these things. These are the some examples for app and asset extension we develop for governance center or WSO2 governance registry. So this is another product, WSO app manager. So here you can see, as I mentioned earlier, so in all other products you can get a single page when you want to add new instance of asset. For example, in this case app, you will get a single page, so where you added this information and finally save it. But here what you can get is wizard. In the left side you can see a number of wizard. That means in app manager they have customized the way enterprise store add new assets. So that is a logical customization. And also as you can see in the storefront, they have integrate subscribe and enterprise subscription, two types of subscriptions, right? And when I come to asset type, so they use two RXGs, web app and mobile app. And life cycle, again they wrote two life cycles, web app life cycle and mobile app life cycles. So this is API manager 2. The API manager 2 use again enterprise store, same thing. You can see they have altered or they have override the asset adding logic, so that you get a wizard instead of a single page. And also this is another extension, tire permissions. These are not out of the box available in the enterprise store, but these are extensions. Then the WSO2 connected store. So the connected store is used with the WSO2 ESB. So if you go there, it use ESB connect as a type, and it has a ES approval life cycle. And these are the some of the extension. Actually this is more or less close to the default or out of the box features. The only extension I can see here is download link. So you can have a download link here in order to download the connector. For example, if you develop an ebook store using enterprise store, you can have a download link there where you can point to the your ebook storage, or you can have a button like a buy, so where you point user to some shopping cart like Amazon or so on. So the another thing is we have experiment is extension reusability. That means, so earlier I discussed the several products like App Manager, API Manager and Governance Center. So can we use a one extension developer a particular product in another place? That is something we experiment and it's succeed. So that is how we supported API Manager features top of the governance registry. So basically API Manager team developed their enterprise store extensions. We just install these features top of the governance registry. Then what we end up is getting API manager capabilities top of the governance registry. So within a single Java bundle, what we got is asset definition, that is the RXT file, and a lifecycle definition, and the asset UI definition and backend capabilities. So this is demonstrated here. So if you go to the right side, the API manager, if you download it API manager, you out of the box get these enterprise store features. And the same times we upload these features into our P2 repository. So in governance registry, what we do, if you want to do API governance with governance registry, what you can do is you can point to P2 repository and you can install the same features into governance registry. Then governance registry also can act as a API manager. So this is how you can use enterprise store features in a different product. This is really a great achievement for us also, because for example in future you can use app manager features in registry, connected device manager features top of the registry, so on. So now the question is how to build your own asset store. So if you want to build asset store, first one is you need to identify what are your digital asset. So it could be a bookstore or it could be a government. So you need to identify what are your assets and list down what are the, each and every attribute of asset. Then you can define them using a RHT. So if you go to our documentation, it has comprehensive a tutorial about how to write new asset. So you define the asset, then you have to define what is the life cycle, what is the life cycle of my asset, and you define life cycle using a SCXML. Then last step is you have to think what are the app extension and asset extension through JavaScript, so you can implement this app and asset extension. So that's what you all need. Basically, this is a five-step task. So next one is, at the moment, we don't have this capability, but we have it in our roadmap. That is the Enterprise Tool Manager. So if you go back very early slide, so I mentioned four components. But that is store, publisher, and console. But we don't have manager yet. So manager is mainly so important for store. So let's imagine this is a screenshot last week I took from Amazon. So this week you had Halloween. So and this they have changed their front page to reflect the Halloween. So in I think in a couple of weeks you have your Black Friday and Cyber Monday. So depend on that, they change the front page. So that is something you also need, right? For example, if I go back to my the previous example, we are the California government. So if you are depend on the time of the year, you want to promote some public park and some stadium like that. So basically, this is not automatically generated. There is a some kind of a human being behind and have some controls. So at the moment, we don't have, but in our roadmap, we are trying to build these capabilities so that you can have a control over your front page. How to and also categorization. Another exciting feature is how to personalize. So in this, a good example is Amazon. So if you visit Amazon and search for some stuff, and when you return on next day, you will be provided the customized or personalized view. So this is something we are planning to inherit into the enterprise store as well. So how to, through this manage app, you can define these personalizations. So at the moment design roadmap, defined as a roadmap items. This is pretty much I want to discuss under this topic.